Hi, and welcome to the Daily Insight. This is for Monday, October 9th. I pulled two cards for love, two cards for career and finance, and I will pull a romance angel card as well. So the first card we have for love is the Eight of Cups, followed by the Six of Wands. So what I'm hearing is there's a group of you that are contemplating walking away from a situation that is you are very emotionally invested in. This could be for a small part of you. This is actually a family member. You love them. It's just the conflict is more than you can take. And you are walking away from that situation. And it's followed by the Six of Wands. So the Six of Wands is successfully achieving a goal. It's victory. It's being cheered for your actions and what took place in this. So you feel by walking away from this family member, because this family member causes you a lot of grief is what I'm hearing for whomever this is applicable for, you're going to feel very victorious when you walk away from this person. Now, for others of you, when it comes to love, what I'm hearing, and it may be a soulmate situation, but what I'm hearing is you've actually vested a lot. You truly love this person, but there is so much dysfunctionality in the relationship. Even though you love them, you know intuitively, you know you need to walk away, and you are actually going to make that move to leave them. So when we see the Eight of Cups, half the cups are up and half the cups are down, which is saying that there's still a lot of emotions involved in this relationship. So for this particular group, when you walk away, you also are going to feel victorious because it's actually a good thing. You're walking away from a dysfunctional relationship. And like I said, this could be a soulmate scenario where in order to move forward, you have to actually walk away. And the romance card that came out is separation. It completely ties in with this reading that I just did for love. So now we're gonna look at career and finance, and I will apply it to love as well. We have the Two of Swords. The Two of Swords is being, you know you need to make a decision, okay? But you don't know which one to do. You're just idle. You aren't sure one way or the other, and it's followed by the Ten of Wands, which also coordinates with the reading that I just did for the love. So again, when we're looking at walking away from a family member, walking away from a love partner, a romantic partner, a relationship that you are fully vested in, you're carrying a lot of the weight on your own. So if we're dealing with a dysfunctional situation, and actually what I heard in regard to walking away from the family member that you're deciding to walk away from, they are narcissist, okay? You feel bad a lot. You love them. So it's somebody very, very close to you when it comes to a family member, but this is just way too much weight on your shoulders. You are having a tremendously difficult time being around them. And that's applicable for either the love, romance, or the family. Both are love. Now, when it comes to career and finance, what I'm hearing is some of you are at a crossroad. You need to make a decision. You feel what's going on in your work environment. Everything's being dumped on you. You literally are carrying the weight, and I'm hearing the word department. So for those of you that are in a department where you may be a lead or a supervisor, you're not the manager, okay? This is still an authority role, but it's not the manager role. This particular group of you, you're carrying all the weight yourself. And you're at the point where you know you need to make a decision. Do I stay or do I go? So, yeah. Now, when you leave, if the group of you that choose to leave, you will feel victorious. Now, if you choose to stay, you are very well aware that this is not going to stop. you know that it is going to be on your shoulders. For some of you, staying may, even though you have all the weight on your shoulders, there is a promotion opportunity coming, okay? This is a 10. That means we are in the completion stage, and after 10 comes zero. We start brand new. So you're ending a cycle within this organization that you work for. Again, this is for the lead or a supervisor, somebody in authority, but they're not the upper level management. If you choose to stay, you will be able, they're going to offer you a promotion, is what I'm hearing. For others, you're going to actually walk away and start a brand new beginning in a different organization, a different career path, possibly. Yeah. So I do hope this helps you, and I wish you to have an absolutely wonderful Monday. Much love.